Talking about marriage right now may seem irrelevant because it's so far off. In his book titled Sacred Marriage, author Gary Thomas writes, "If there is one thing young couples need to hear, it's that a good marriage is not something you find, it's something you work for. It takes struggle. You must crucify your selfishness."
To plan for a healthy and godly marriage in the future, it helps to know what that looks like now. Know what Scripture says. That's the foundation. Read Bible-centered sources about marriage. They can also help.
In their book, Boundaries in Marriage, authors Cloud and Townsend list abilities that each partner in a marriage needs to have in order to have a healthy marriage. Some of them include: connect emotionally, be vulnerable and share feelings, say no, have initiative, have some organizational skills, be real, accept imperfection and forgive, think for oneself, learn and grow, take risks, be responsible and follow through, be sexual, be spiritual, have a moral sense, and have an intellectual life.
Of course, there are many lists of things that are ideal for a healthy marriage. But the point is that marriage is not to be entered into lightly or just because of butterflies. Having a healthy marriage takes work from both people in the relationship.
Author Barbara Rainey writes, "Marriages are like churches. Some are grand in scale like cathedrals, while others more closely resemble a small country parish. The power of any church is not in its size, but in its people who are alive with the life of Christ. Marriage must be filled with the Spirit of Christ, each spouse humbly following his leadership. If we want to be all it was built to be, then, like a church spire, our lives and the beauty of our marriage will irresistibly draw others in and point them to God, the Redeemer of our unique marriage story."
God designed marriage. He created it as a good thing. We can enjoy happiness in and through marriage. But we can also enjoy happiness without marriage. So happiness isn't the goal. The goal, in fact, is the same goal God has in everything he designed: to bring him glory and to make us more like him, also known as holiness. Marriage brings two people together into a united relationship physically and spiritually in such a way that it's intended to reflect Christ and his relationship to us, the church.